Hi, I'm Ms. Terry, and I work at the West Regional Branch of Mobile Public Library. One program that we offer here at the library for preschoolers and toddlers is called Create, Play, Learn. And in that program, we put out activities that will help them with fine motor, gross motor, writing, and sensory. So what I'd like to share today is something that you can do at home with the things that you have at home, or it's something that you can easily purchase at a dollar store or at the big box stores. It's fun to go into the dollar store and walk through the aisles and see what you can use to let them create and work with different things and play. I've also added a board to our Pinterest called Create, Play, Learn with Ms. Terry, and I'll put a link down below so that you can go to that and check it out. It's got different activities. I've divided them onto different sections, so just check that out and see. I'll try to add to that periodically. Today we're talking about water and what they can do, because everybody has water. If you don't like to get messy, then this is probably not bad to play with. You can do it outside, you can do it inside, you can contain it. If you do it outside, you can get a kid's plastic tub and let them play around with it. But we're doing, today I've got measuring and bowls that they can pour into and pour out of. Let them practice with not as much water, maybe, because they might spill it, make a mess. These are something that we got off of Amazon. There was a whole bunch, and they're just disposable things that you can let them drop water on things. They can put water in a sponge. You can use cotton balls. You can get cotton balls wet. You can use the turkey baster, and they can squeeze to use their fine motors, get those muscles built up in their hands, and they can blow bubbles with the different things in the water. Maybe you have to learn how to use this better than Miss Terry. They can transfer the water. It's good for those muscles in their hands. They can whisk it, and they can take other utensils that you have in your kitchen, and they can pretend like they're making something, and they can pour it from one container into another. You can use a spray bottle. They have little small spray bottles, put water in it. Let them go outside and spray the water everywhere outside. That strengthens those muscles. And someday, soon, they'll be school and they will be riding, so they will need those muscles strengthened. It seems like with technology, all we have to do is swipe, and it's not that difficult to touch for the touch screen. So those muscles don't necessarily get built up like they should, so that they can write when it comes time for school. You could use leftover empty containers. Let them pour into the container and pour out of a container. It's also good for them to screw the lids on and off. That's a task that they can enjoy learning how to do. Stirring with popsicle sticks, or I've got chopsticks. If you take water in an ice cube tray, freeze it, or just plain ice cubes, not with anything inside. You could freeze little toys inside an ice cube and let them play with it till it thaws out. Outside, it wouldn't be very long before it would be melted. And they could see how the water melts, and then they can get whatever's inside, a Lego or whatever. You can also let them pour into an ice tray and pour out of the ice tray. They can do all kinds of things with just the utensils in your kitchen. So let them at it, let them have some fun. The possibilities are endless, and the key is to have fun. Thanks for joining me today. Bye.